Good morning. Welcome back to my Learn with Tom Lee, Español Esencial, the Spanish Essential, 西班牙文的基础。Adjetivo possessivo, the possessive adjective, 拥有形容词。Los adjetivos possessivos. Possessive adjectives must agree in gender and number singular or plural with the object that are possessed. They never agree with the possessors.And below is a table of possessive adjectives. In English, we have my, your, his, her, or your. And ours, yours, this is the your in plural. And their, your. And this your is also in plural form. And in Spanish, if this is masculine singular,Me, tú, su, nuestro, vuestro, su, and in plural masculine, mis, tú, sus, nuestros, vuestros, sus, feminized singular, me, tú, su, nuestra, vuestra, su, feminized plural.Mis, tus, sus, nuestra, vuestra, su. Los adjetivos posesivos. Let me see some example. Yo pedí mis gafas. Because gafa is feminized plural, so the possessive adjective have to be agree with the possess. And it's never agree with the possessor.So you have to remember this. If we're talking in here, I lost my glasses. Glasses is plural form, so the my in here, we use the plural form of mis, not me. Nosotros escuchamos a nuestro profesor. And because in here, profesor is the masculine singular form, so we use the nuestro in masculine singular.Nosotros escuchamos a nuestro profesor. We listen to our teacher. Because su can mean his, her, or their. You can clarify who the possessor really is by replacing the possessive adjective su with the corresponding definite article el, la, los, or las. Plus the noun, plus their,And plus L, ellos, ellas, ellas, usted or ustedes. For example, I need her help. Necesito su ayuda. Su may be mean her help or his help or their help. So if you want to clarify, you can write necesito la ayuda de él, of him or of her.With parts of the body or clothing, you replace the possessive adjective with the correct definite article when the possessor is clear. For example, me cepillo los dientes dos veces al día. I purse, cepillos mean I purse, los dientes, the teeth. So we know that the teeth mean my teeth, so this los is represent my. You don't need the possessive adjective mis. You use los. Dientes dos veces al día. Twice a day. Dos veces. Two times. Al día. A day. El pronombre de objetos directo. The direct object pronoun. In both English and Spanish, a direct object pronoun follows the subject and its verb. For example,Veo la casa. I see the house. Unlike in English, however, you usually place a Spanish direct object pronoun before the conjugate verb. La veo. It means I see it. La is it. It, I see. We place the la before the veo. I see. Lista de pronombre directos del objetos.The list of the direct object pronoun. We use me for me, de for you, lo for him, it or you, la for her, it or you, and nos for us, os for you in polite form, los for them or you, and las for them or the plural you. We see some example down here. El me comprende. He understand me. Nos ve usted. Do you see us? Or you do see us. Usted is you. Ve is see. And nos is us. Us, you see. Or us, see you. That means, do you see us? Do you see us? Nos ve usted. And the third example, los periódicos, the newspaper. Yo los leo cada día. Leo, this means I read. Yo leo, I read cada día, every day. And los, I read them every day. The newspaper, I read them every day. Continue with the la lista de pronombres directos del objeto, the list of the direct object pronoun. People often use le rather than lo in Spain to express you masculine or him. They use lo is used as a direct object pronoun in Spain, America. The plural of lo and les is los, which means them or you. Here are some examples. Cuidos la niños. I watch, this means I take care our niños to the child. This means I watch the child or I care the child. And I care him. I write the him first. Lo or le cuidos. Him, I care. Or him, I watch. Cuido a los niños. I watch the children. That means I care the children. If I change it to I care them or I watch them, so I said them I care. Los cuidos or les cuidos. Miro a programa. I watch the program. Miro mean I watch or I see the program. If I want to say I watch it, so it lo miro. Because programa is a masculine singular, so I use it lo miro. I watch it, or literally it I watch. Miro los programas. I watch the programs. And this los programa is masculine and plural form. So I use the masculine plural form of them, los miros. I watch them. You use the personal are before a common or proper noun that's referred to a person or persons. The personal are combines with the definite article el to form the contraction al, but it doesn't combine with other definite article. For example, no conozco a ella. I don't understand or I don't know, because conozco is I know or I understand. No conozco. No, I understand. This means I don't understand or I don't know a ella. Ella is the feminized them. And this sentence means I don't know them. No conozco a ella. I don't know to them. Busco al señor Gomez. Busco mean I find to señor Gomez. So this one actually is al, and we contract it to al. Busco al señor Gomez. I am looking for Mr. Gomez. You use the personal are before the name of your pooch. Pooch mean a dog. Tabby. Tabby mean a cat with a dark mark on the gray of brown hair. Hamster. Hamster is a rostrum look like a mouse, turtles, or other pet. Adiestro affido. Adiestro mean the past tense of tame. Affido, she tamed to fiddle. We use the personal in here before a pet fiddle. You use the personal before a pronoun that's refer to a person. And this is a pronoun, nobody or anyone, anybody. No espero, I don't wait. This means I wait. And no esperos mean I don't wait. I am not waiting. A nadie to anyone or for anyone. No espero a nadie. I am not waiting for anyone or I don't wait for anyone. You don't, however, use the personal with the verb tener. If you use the verb tener to have, you don't use after it. Tengo dos hermanos. I have two brother. Dos hermanos, two brother, and tengos mean I have. And you don't need tengo a dos hermanos because the verb tener, we don't use after it. Directo del objeto, direct object. Le escribo un email. Escribo mean I write an email to him or to her. I'm writing an email to him or I write an email to him. Le escribo a Gloria un email. I write to Gloria an email. And in Spanish, we also add the word le before the escribo. If we drop the word le, also mean I write an email to Gloria. But most of the time, we use the word le before the escribo. Le escribo a Gloria un email. I am writing an email to Gloria. Le compro un libro. Compro, I buy a book to him or to her. Le compro un libro. I buy a book to him or to her. Te compro un libro. I buy a book to you. And te is the direct object. You. I buy a book to you. Te compro un libro. I buy a book to you. If you translate into English. And me compra un libro. Compra, he buy, or you buy, she buy a book to me. So this one, if you translate to English, you have, she buy a book to me. And in Spanish, we say it's me, she buy, or he buys a book. And this means she buys a book to me. Indirecto del objeto, indirect object. In singular pronoun, we use me for or to me, de to or for you, feminized, le to or for him, for her or for you, informal. Nos is to us or for us, and os is to you, plural, and for you, plural, feminized. Les is to them, to you, in formal plural. For example, me dice la breda. You tell the truth to me. This me is to me. And in here is a question. So me dice la breda. That means, do you tell the truth to me? Are you telling the truth? Second example, la mujer nos ofrece. La mujer is the woman. Nos ofrece, offer us un refresco, a soft drink, a refreshing. La mujer nos ofrece un refresco. The woman offer us a drink or a refresh. Le doy un abrazo. Doy mean I give un abrazo, a hug. I give a hug to them. Les doy un abrazo. I give them a hug. Directos del objeto. Yo le escribo a Rosa. I write to Rosa. And le is referred to Rosa. Yo le escribo a Rosa. I write to Rosa. Yo le escribo. I write to her. Ella le habla al muchacho. Ella means she speak to the boy. And le refer to the boy. Ella le habla al muchacho. She speak to the boy. Ella le habla. She speaks to him. Ella le habla a él. She speaks to him. And le is referred to él. Ella le habla a Juan. She speaks to Juan. And le is also referred to Juan. And in here, you have to remember, in English, we seldom use this le. So, she speaks to Juan. Ella habla a Juan. But in Spanish, we always added le, or los, or la, in front of it. Te compro un regalo. I buy you a gift. I buy a gift to you. I'm buying a person for you, or I'm buying you a person. Me escriben. They write to me. That means they write a letter, or they write something to me. Me escriben. To me, they write. They are writing to me, or they are writing me a letter or something. And now we have to choosing the proper pronoun for the sentence. Sometimes people get confused when trying to figure out whether to use a direct object pronoun or an indirect object pronoun. The good news is that you will have absolutely no problem with the me, de, nos, or os, because they act as both direct and indirect object pronoun. They are also reflexive pronouns. And what is reflexive pronoun? We will talk about it in chapter 3. Me respeta. He respects me, or she respects me. Me dice un secreto. He tell or she tell a secret to me. And this is an indirect pronoun, because what he tells is a secret. And me is the indirect pronoun. He tell me a secret. Nos visita. He visit or she visits us, or to us. This is the direct pronoun, because he visits us, she visits us. Us is the direct object pronoun. She visits us. Nos visita. Nos trae flores. He brings or she brings flower to us. So us in here is the indirect object pronoun. She brings us flower, or she brings flower to us. And some common Spanish words requiring a direct object pronoun: buscar, to look for; escuchar, to listen to; esperar, to wait for; llamar, to call, or to call by a phone; mirar, to look at. For example, nosotros esperamos a nuestros amigos. Esperamos means we are waiting our friends. Nosotros esperamos a nuestros amigos. And if I want to say we are waiting for them, nosotros los esperamos. We are them waiting. This means we are waiting for them. Los here is referred to nuestro amigo. The common Spanish words requiring an indirect object: acompañar, to accompany; aconsejar, to advise; contar, to relate or to tell; contestar, to answer; dar, to give; decir, to say or to tell; enviar, to send; escribir, to write; explicar, to expand; llamar, to call; mandar, to send; obedecer, to obey; ofrecer, to offer; pedir, to ask or to ask for; preguntar, to ask; presentar, to introduce; prestar, to lend; prohibir, to forbid; prometer, to promise; regalar, to give a gift; telefonear, to call. And see some example. De aconsejo, I advise you; practicar más, to practice more. De aconsejo practicar más, I advise you to practice more. Ella le pide. Pide means she asks. Le, her or him. Ella le pide, she asks her or she asks him. Disculpar a su amiga. It also means she asks her friend for an apology. Doing an about face with Gustav. In English, you may say, I like chocolates. But in Spain, You say it's the other way round, like chocolate is pissing to me. Me gusta. Gusta means pissing. Me, it means it pissing me. What pissing me is el chocolate. Me gusta el chocolate. The chocolate pissing me, it means I like chocolate. The foreign table presents other Spanish words that work like gusta. This gusta to upset this piece. For example, me disgusta el chocolate. That means the chocolate upset me. I don't like chocolate. Fada to lack or to need. Fascinar to fascinate. Importar to be important. If you say no importar, it means I don't care. It is not important to me. Interesar to interest. Parecer to seem. If you say que parece, that means what do you think? Quedar to remain to someone or have left. For example, te gustan los deportes. Los deportes mean the sport. Gustan, pissing, and they pissing you. And in this question, it means do the sport pissing you? Do you like sport? Literally, are sports pissing to you? No interesa viajar. Viajar means to travel. The travels interest us, and it means we like to travel. We are interested in traveling, or literally, traveling is interesting to us. Me gusta cantar. To sing, please me. This means I like to sing. Me gusta cantar y bailar. Cantar is to sing, bailar is to stand. And to sing, to stand, please sing me. And this means I like to sing and dance. And the following list presents some small details you should know about using this word. An indirect object pronoun may be preceded by the preposition are, plus the corresponding prepositional pronoun. Me, ti, él, ella, usted, nosotros, vosotros, ellos, ellas, or ustedes. For strength or clarification, we see in chapter 4. A mí me parece caros. For me, this means a mí. It seems clear to me. Me parece caros can mean it seems clear to me. If I add to me in the beginning of the sentence, it makes it more stressed and clarified. A mí me parece caros. For me, it seems clear to me. An indirect object pronoun may be preceded by the preposition a, plus the indirect object pronoun. A Miguel, to Miguel, no le gusta trabajar. The work doesn't fit him. Miguel doesn't like to work. A Miguel no le gusta trabajar. Michael doesn't like to work. A las niñas les gusta el verano. The ice cream pissed the girls, pissed them. So to the girls, the ice cream pissed them. This means the girls like ice cream. A las niñas les gusta el verano. How to position the object pronouns. How do you decide where to place a direct or indirect object pronoun in Spanish? Generally, you place these pronouns before the conjugate word. For example, nosotros los necesitamos. Necesitamos means we need. Los is them. We place the them before this word. So it's before this word. We, them, we need. That means we need them. Nosotros los necesitamos. Siempre les cuesta chistes. You always tell them joke. Tell the jokes, chistes. Cuesta. Tell them the joke. Siempre is always and literally mean always them you tell the joke. With a person participle. For example, I am or I am not doing it. It, I am doing. Estoy haciendo. I am doing. I am doing what? I am doing it. Lo estoy haciendo. I am doing it. If you say I am not doing it, you place the not in front of it. No lo estoy haciendo. I am not doing it. No estoy haciéndolo. And you can also put the haciendo, I am doing, and the it after the haciendo. And we join these two words together into one word. Estoy haciéndolo. I am doing it. No estoy haciéndolo. I am not doing it. You can either use the first form or the second form. With an infinitive, for example, lo quiero hacer. I want to do it. And this is the infinitive to do. It, I want to do. Lo quiero hacer. No lo quiero hacer. I don't want to do it. You can also take the lo after the word hacer and join these two words together into one. So, quiero hacerlo. I want to do it. No quiero hacerlo. I don't want to do it. And now we are looking for some affirmative sentence. Preparelas. Prepare it. And this is a command. If you tell the boy to prepare something or tell someone to prepare something with a command, you just say prepárela, prepare it. Hazlo, do it. Now take a look at the negative. No la prepare. Don't prepare it. Don't it prepare. No lo hagas. Don't do it. And doing double duty. When the verb has two object pronouns, the indirect object pronoun, a person, precedes the direct object pronoun, usually a thing. Ellos nos muestras la revista. Muestra means to show us. She asked to show la revista, the magazine. And it means she show us the magazine. And if we take the magazine, la revista, into a pronoun, so ella nos las muestra. She to us, them show. This means she show them to us. She show them to us. Ellas nos las muestra. Nosotros te damos el boleto. We give you the ticket. Damos means we give. De is you. Nosotros te damos. We give you. We give you what? We give you the ticket. El boleto. We can say we give it to you, and we will say in Spanish, nosotros te los damos. We to you, it to give. That means we give it to you. We give it to you, nosotros te lo damos. And when a sentence has two first person object pronouns, the indirect object pronouns le or les change to se before the direct object pronoun lo, la, los or las. For example, el les leer las revistas a sus abuelos. He reads the magazines to his grandparents. El is he, leer la revista, the magazines, and the magazine is plural. A su abuelo, abuelos mean his grandparents, and les is referred to sus abuelos. And if we change the sentence to he reads them to them, reads them, this one is the magazine, and to them, this one is the grandparents. So we change it to él se las leía. He reads the magazine to his grandparents. Él se las leía. To clarify the meanings of se, because it can be mean to or for you, to or for him, to or for her, or for them. You may include the phrase a usted, a ustedes, a es, a ellos, a ellas, or a ellas. J yo se los digo a ellos. Yo se los digo mean I tell them to him. Yo se los digo. I tell them to him or to her. If you want is to him or to her, you add the a else, a ella, or a ustedes. Yo se los digo. I tell them to him, a else, or a ella, or to her. With an infinitive, you may place the two separate pronouns before the conjugate verb, or you may connect and attach them to the end of the infinitive. For example, de los quiero mostrar. I want to show them to you. De los quiero mostrar. You, them, I want to show. And it also means I want to show them to you. And in the negative form, you just add the no in front of it. No de los quiero mostrar. I don't want to show them to you. No quiero mostrar dele. I want to show mostrar to you and them. To show them to you. Mostrar dele. Connect into one word. Quiero mostrar dele. I want to show them to you. No quiero mostrar dele. I don't want to show them to you. With a person participle, you may place the two separate pronouns before the conjugated form of the estar, or you may connect and attach them to the end of the gerund. For example, se la estoy leyendo a él, I am reading to him. Reading what? Reading it. It, I am reading to him. That means I'm reading it to him. And this se means him. Se la estoy leyendo a él. Or no se la estoy leyendo a él. I am not reading it to him. You can also join this word together into leyéndosela. This means I am reading it to him. And this se is also referred to a él, to him. Estoy leyéndosela a él. I am reading it to him. And with commands, formals, affirmative, dígamelo, tell it to me. If you command someone to tell something to you, you say, tell it to me. And you may say, dígamelo. Negative, no me lo diga. Don't tell it to me. No me lo diga. Diga is tell it to me. And no me lo diga. Don't tell it to me. And the informal form, affirmative, dímelo, tell it to me. If you talk to a friend, you can say, dímelo, tell it to me, or no me lo digas, don't tell it to me. And the negative of the formal or the informal form is the same. And finally, when you attach two pronouns to an infinitive, you generally count back three vowels and add an essence. Yo voy a escribirlo a usted. I am going to write it to you. This is to write it to you. A usted is to you. Because this say here can mean to him or to her. So you have to ask a usted and confirm it is to you. Yo voy a escribirlo a usted. I am going to write it to you. When you add two pronouns to a person participle or an affirmative command, however, you generally count back four vowels when acting an essence. Estamos comprándoselas a ellos. We are buying it for them. Se is mean to them. And comprando, we are buying. Estamos comprando. We are buying. Se las, buying it to them. Ellos is to them. Muéstramelo. Show it to me. Muéstra is to show it to me. With a deep one, two vowels band together that stand for only one vowel sound, you may have to count back as many as five vowels. Díganoslos. Bring them to us. This is to us and this is them. And here is to bring. to bring them to us. Bring them to us. That is ganaros. Okay, this is the end of the chapter 2, and I will see you guys on the next chapter, chapter 3. Okay, if you think this video is good and can help you, please subscribe and give like. So you press the button at the lower right corner to subscribe. And remember, when I have a new videos, you better click the bell sharp and see the new video. Thank you. Muchas gracias. Again, thank you very much for listening to my tutorial videos. And if you need a private tutor for you to get a better mark or better score in your DSC examination in Hong Kong, the SAT examination, or just you want to improve your mathematics and English for your college and university study, please contact me at qingtong929@yahoo.com.hk. My telephone number is +1 852 6592 8609. 好多谢大家收听我呢个 video。如果你希望你个 mathematics 同埋你个英文系更加好嘅话咧，你想要一个 private tutor 啦，你可以随时 contact 我嘅，令到你个 DSE exam 啦，或者你想考 SAT 啦，你亦都可以 contact 我，因为我都有一啲私人嘅补习喺呢一两方面嘅。多谢大家 ，thank you， 拜拜 ，muchas gracias。